Hi friends, today I'm going to discuss about this sequential organ failure assessment. This is one of the scores which is used to predict the outcome in sepsis. Sepsis is one thing in which the infection from one part of the body spreads to various organs of the body. For example, if the patient has urosepsis, that is related to urinary tract or kidney, he may develop sepsis as the infection from kidneys spread to various other bodies, other parts of bodies and other vital organs of the bodies. And we have some predictors. Based on this, we can say whether the patient will improve or will deteriorate. This will be, we can assess regard with some support of some calculations. So regarding first one, respiratory system, that is partial O2 pressure to fractional inspired oxygen levels ratio. And with this, we can assess the respiratory function. So if PaO2 by FiO2 is more than 400, it is normal and 0 points will be given. If it is more than 400, 0 points will be given. And it is less than or equal to 100 with ventilatory support. This is given as the highest points, 4 points will be given for this. And if it is more than 400, 0 points will be given for this. Coming to inotrope support, this is regarding to blood pressure. If patient don't have a hypotension, it will be given 0 points. And the patient is requiring high level of inotropic support, that is dopamine more than 15 mcg per kg per minute. Or epinephrine more than 0.1 mcg per kg per minute. Then that will be given as the highest number of points, 4 points. And the next one is bilirubin level. This is hepatic. The first one respiratory, second one cardiovascular, and the third one is hepatic. If the bilirubin level is less than 1.2, this is normal. And 0 points will be given for this. If it is more than 12, it will be given 4 points. And the next one, platelet concentration. Platelet concentration will become less in sepsis. So the normal value is more than 1.5 lakh, and it will be given as 0 points. And if it is less than 20,000, this will be given 4 points. And coming to GCS, that is brain, if the GCS is 15, it is normal, 15 by 15 is normal, then it will be given as 0 points. And if it is less than 6, it will be given as 4 points. And in between, there are some things, some values like 13 to 14, 10 to 12, 6 to 9 and less than 6. And I am not discussing all the in-between things. I am only discussing about the 0, for when we will give 0 points and when we will be giving 4 points. And in between there are some values in between those things. And the last one is kidney, renal function, serum creatinine and urine output. So if the creatinine is less than 1.2, it will be given 0 points. And if the creatinine is more than 5, or the urine output is less than 200 ml per day, then it will be given as 4 points. So we have 6 criteria, and each one 4, 4, 4, 4, 4. So 6 fours are 24 points. 24 points is the maximum number in SOFA score. So the SOFA score helps predict morbidity rather than mortality. Though individuals with a score of 15 or more than 15 or more, they had mortal rate of 90% mortal rate will be there. The SOFA score is more than 15. Or more than or equal to 15, the mortality rate is 90%. So And all these require some laboratory support and some skills to assess the SOFA score. Recently, they have found this new one, qSOFA. Q means quick. Quick SOFA score has been formulated. Whether it has very simple things to predict the prognosis in a sepsis patient. One is if respiratory rate is more than 22 breaths per minute, this will be given as 1 point. And if the altered mentation means any GCS less than 15 can be taken. GCS 15 is normal, and if it is less than 15, that is, or less than or equal to 14, it will be given as 1 point. And whereas SPB, that is systolic blood pressure, is if it is less than or equal to 100 mmHg, it will be given 1 point. So here, a positive qSOFA score more than or equal to 2, if any two of these or all the three of these are present, this suggests high risk of poor outcome in patients with suspected infection. These patients should be more thoroughly assessed for evidence of any organ dysfunction. A positive qSOFA score by itself should not trigger sepsis-directed interventions like initiation of broad-spectrum antibiotics. Rather, it should prompt us to further investigations for the presence of any MODS, organ dysfunction, or we have to increase the frequency of monitoring. So, at first we have to do this quick SOFA score to assess whether the patient needs any further investigations, or we have to assess them thoroughly for evidence of any organ dysfunction, and in-depth investigation should be done to find where the septic foci is. So this is all regarding this SOFA and qSOFA. So thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.